If you imagine an RPG game, usually you see a giant map that represents the entire game world. It's sort of how I look at game dev. You start with nothing in your default town, and then there's many different areas. There's programming, art, both 3D and 2D. There's sound, which might include ambient music as well as sound effects. There's voice acting, which is related to the storyline, which is another area. There's VFX, there's game design, and then there's the business aspect of game development, marketing, budget, management, your overall strategy. You also need strategy in life because you gotta pay the bills and all that. On my channel, I like to focus on programming. One, because I like it. Two, just like how a car is an engine, it's your code that makes your game interactive and playable. Otherwise, you're making a movie. Obviously, it doesn't mean it's the only thing that's important. A lot of times the areas overlap and they're all connected through many different roads. And literally everybody takes a different path and has a different experience. This doesn't represent everything in the world of game dev. There's areas that I don't really know about. There might be ones I forgot to mention in this video, but the point being, it's a giant world for you to explore, and if there's one thing that I know for sure, it's that game dev takes a lot of time and effort. Oftentimes you hear me calling out those who are looking for shortcuts. Imagine that the boss is sitting right there. Every day you hear about giant commercial success of AAA games, or sometimes it's smaller, but there's also a considerable amount of sales coming from indie game developers or smaller studios. You hear about them in social media and everywhere else, so you kind of feel like they're right next to you. But if you've just entered this world and you have nothing, if you go straight to the boss and try to kill it, you'll do nothing. No matter how many times you try, you'll die over and over again. You won't even cause a single damage. You'll get frustrated, and in most cases, you're just wasting your time. We know there's another way. There's many quests that you can do before facing the boss, and over long periods of time, you obtain skills or items that improve your stats, and basically you level up. If you spend 12 hours going straight to the boss, you might as well achieve nothing. If you take the seemingly longer route, you can be spending the same 12 hours achieving smaller goals here and there with more efficiency, and the journey will be much more enjoyable that way. You'll be gaining confidence every time you get something done, and what seems like a path that takes you further away from the boss is actually a path that will make your kill more efficient. This is a very long-term plan. Every one of these areas have sub-areas, and every sub-area has more sub-areas, and it just goes on and on. If you zoom into programming, there's many topics or quests that you can dive into. I've listed some books and other sources in the links below. Understand that these are just few examples that I can think of off the top of my head, and there's so much more info out there if you just Google things. You'll find out that people have different opinions, and each of them will suggest different paths. But generally, you need to understand math, both 2D and 3D geometry, trigonometry, vectors and quaternions, data structures and algorithms, design patterns and architecture. Before you even touch a game engine like Unity, you should already be well experienced in creating your own piece of software, or customized code that solves specific problems. This alone could take years. Some people learn it as they're working with Unity, but I find this extremely rare. Whatever your method of learning is, you need to be able to read and write code. On a side note, I see some people looking at visual scripting as a shortcut to not learn to code, but it is code, it's just a different representation. It's part of the learning process, not a magic wand that'll make your life easier. There's one link that I find fascinating. It's not exactly related to game dev, but more like learning how to learn. The video includes many tips, but one of them I find highly effective almost immediately. You measure the time you start doing a task, and at first your brain is fresh. You're able to focus pretty much 100%. But as you go on, you'll feel yourself starting to lose that focus and being frustrated. That's when you stop and record the time again. You'll find that your focus only lasts somewhere around 20 minutes. Depending on how you're feeling at the time or how challenging or unfamiliar the task is, it could be less, like 10 minutes. Once you lose your focus, you take a break, and that's when your brain subconsciously reorganizes everything. You can spend time thinking about what you just learned, which will help you understand the underlying concept. You can also move on to other tasks or come back when your brain is fresh, and you can have your focus again. Eventually, the focus time increases and you're able to get more done without being frustrated. Once I started doing this a while ago, I found out that I was no longer afraid of learning new things, for example, drawing. I've been venturing off into other areas like art, and this single video helped me drastically change how I spend my time learning and researching, and it literally feels like now I have more time during the day. Sometimes, of course, it does help to push through the frustration and sit down for hours and hours trying to figure something out. There's many different tips online on learning, and you'll have to find out what works for you and customize your methods. Maybe later I'll feel confident enough to share my own art and use it in my own game instead of trying to hire an artist. Who knows? Back to the main point. It's a giant world and there's many quests that can help you improve and do more quests in the future, and eventually you might be able to kill a boss, or at least a mini boss. If you don't like this long process, you might actually hate game dev. It's like how most people like BMWs, but when it comes to understanding the math and physics behind it, most people are not interested. You might enjoy playing video games, but when it comes to understanding a piece of software, there's a good chance you might hate it. A lot. If you find yourself not wanting to learn code, only looking for answers that come through clicking or dragging things in the Unity interface, or expecting your first game to make sales, you might want to rethink your commitment. If you don't like programming, there's many different paths, but none of them can be taken lightly. They all require a significant amount of time and effort. I started out like most people though. I thought downloading CryEngine would allow me to build a AAA game and make millions of dollars. But eventually I found joy in coding. It was completely unexpected, but now even a few well-written lines of code make me happy. Every time I learn something new or run a successful little experiment, I feel like I've done a quest, and it all builds up, which will help me get closer to achieving my goals. One of my side quests is learning to be an artist. I have no idea how I'll do, but to me, game development itself is like playing a video game. It's all part of the fun. I hope you feel the same way and not ask about how to kill the boss on your first day. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.